Well, Brown's mini camp is over here in Berea. Day three is in the books. They will all go their separate ways until training camp reconvenes at the end of July. So let's talk about some takeaways, what we saw here this week during mini camp. Mary Kay, what was a big takeaway for you?
Well, I think you have to start with Odell Beckham Jr. He's finally here. He showed up. He worked really hard. Now, he wasn't in team drills today. They took some precautions. They left him and Duke Johnson out of the 11-on-11s because they hadn't been here for all the voluntary stuff. So, but when we did see OBJ out there, you know, his talent just shines. It stands out above the rest. And he's going to work hard with Baker in the offseason, and I think he will be ready to roll by training camp.
Scott, takeaway.
You know, I think it's the cornerbacks, the young cornerbacks on this team, Denzel Ward and Greedy Williams. Greedy working with the first team pretty much exclusively here in minicamp, and we've seen him go up against Odell Beckham Jr. and kind of experience that, and he's really come a long way since rookie camp when he kind of looked a little lost at times, like a rookie. So the cornerbacks and how well they've done, they picked off Baker Mayfield a few times over this mini camp. So they've really shined, and I think they're giving the Browns what they want out of that group.
I think the thing that stood out to me, you mentioned that, of course, Baker Mayfield has gotten picked off a few times. But, I mean, this really is Baker Mayfield's team now. You know, this time a year ago, Baker Mayfield was behind Tyrod Taylor. It was really Tyrod Taylor's team at this point. And I think this camp, even with some of the struggles on the field, and a lot of that has to do with not having his top receivers out there, this is Baker Mayfield's football team. He was the leader out there. He was vocal. And you could tell that guys gravitated to him. And the zip on the football, we saw flashes of it last year, but now, of course, we're seeing it with consistency. And when you get a chance to see it up close, which is rare during the season, but we really get to see it this time of year, Mary Kay, it's really impressive.
Yeah, it really is. And I mean, you know, I look out there and I think, gosh, this is going to be a hard offense to defend against, because even when it seems like he could be under pressure or under siege or in a little bit of trouble, he can just escape it and nail that ball wherever he wants it to go. We see that every single practice, every time we're out here, and it is pretty incredible to watch. And like you said, he has really taken charge in ways that maybe he didn't even last year, in terms of yelling at guys to get back to the huddle. He was jawing with the referees today when they didn't call a touchdown on a trick play. And he really is putting his own stamp on this offense.
And one more for me, another one that has stood out, Rashard Higgins. It happened last spring. All he did was catch footballs. It's happening again. All he's doing, Scott, is catching footballs from Baker Mayfield. Anything else kind of stand out to you here before we wrap up?
You know, the offense, I think it's easy to see the progress because there's no tackling. But that defensive line, there were so many times when Myles Garrett is basically standing in front of Baker Mayfield with his arms out as if, okay, I've won this play. But they got to let him keep going because they want to get through the rep. So seeing this defensive line when they come back in the fall and actually being able to get into preseason games and go after people, it's going to be something that I think I'm really looking forward to.
All right, so minicamp is over. It's the last day of school, kind of, here in Berea. They'll reconvene at the end of July for training camp. Of course, a lot of guys are going to work out together in LA during the offseason, so the work doesn't stop. It's just not going to happen here. We'll have full coverage of everything that happened during the 3 days, all at cleveland.com/browns.